So, I'm going to conclude tonight. The whole series we start few months ago, I think 4 or 5 months ago. And we start like a practical study about the Bible. And we saw like, what is the Bible, how to read the Bible, what to expect from the Bible, and how to apply the Word of God to my life. Tonight I'm going to conclude with the last two points from the last section that Cipri and Cipri started like I think 4 weeks ago, and I want to quiz you a little bit, ask you some questions about at least about this last section. And the first question for you is: do you know or do you remember what's the title of this last section that we study? You don't have to be 100% exact to the point, just like an idea of what was the theme, the title of our last section. Probably not. I wouldn't have not known if I wouldn't have to be here, probably. So I'm not trying to point fingers or anything at that. I don't want to put on the spot. How about the 4 points that we were going through 4 weeks ago and 3 weeks ago? That's even harder, right? Okay, I'm going to stop here. So the theme, the title was Maintaining a Heart for God. One of my favorite pastors said in one of his Bible studies is that the most important thing for a Christian is to not to love God. When we stop to love God, when we stop to maintain a heart and a passion for God, is when we are in trouble. And most of the time applies to who's in a ministry. Why is that? Because Satan is trying to hit us with so many temptations, and when he sees that he can't anymore, what he's trying to do, he says he wants to put like a love in our heart, a love for the ministry rather than a love for God. And the secret for Christians is to maintain a heart for God. And this is the theme, the subject of our last session. Now the 4 points, we had 4 points so far, and I'm going to have two more. The very first point was how important it is to build my life on the Word of God. And the passage was from Matthew 7 and 24. The second one was to feed on the Word of God. Not just to build, but to feed on the Word of God. And the passage was from Colossians 3:16. The third point was, I must live by the Word of God. And we find the passage for that subject in Psalm 119, verse 11. And the last point was, I must grow through the Word of God. Psalm 19, verse 18. Now, I want to do like a practical, I want to challenge you to something. I want you to think, picture you, right? Picture you on a sofa, crying, or on your knees, praying to God. Or you're driving your car and you're pounding the steering wheel, like very angry on yourself. Nothing, nobody else, but on yourself. Now, how did you end up in this situation? Let's take us back probably a week or 2 weeks or 3 weeks ago, when after fighting a sin or a huge problem of our life, and we fight and we fight and we fight, but we keep singing, we keep failing. The situation we're in, it's so heavy and so deep, we just cannot get out of it. But it came a day, a moment, when God says, it's enough. From now on, you're a free man. You're not struggling with the sin anymore. You're not struggling with the situation anymore. I made you free. Rejoice. And you're happy. And you're full of life. You want to do so many things. But as it happened before, you're going to end up sinning again. Satan is going to come with even worse situations in your life, and you're in the same situation, crying, being despaired, and being angry on yourself and saying, how did I allow this to happen to me again? It happened 40 times, 60 times, 100 times. It happens again. When it's going to stop? When I'm going to stop this cycle of going down and God lift me up and then sinning again? When I'm going to stop singing? When I'm going to stop saying it's enough? I had enough. When? And how did you end in this situation? First of all, I want to say, because you didn't follow the four steps that we've been talked about so far. You didn't build. Once you heard the word of God, once God made you a free man, instead of you building on the word of God, you didn't. And because you didn't build your life on the word of God, you didn't live by the word of God. And definitely you never fed yourself from the word of God. And when you don't feed yourself and don't live by the word of God, you're going to die. You're going to get so vulnerable, and then Satan is going to hit you again. And that's why me and you, we end up so many times in situations like that. When after God raises up from the death, we end up in a worse or the same situation that we've been before. My question is, when me and you are going to stop this? That leads me to my fifth point, which is I must act on it. It's pointless if you guys just come here and listen to the word of God and do nothing. It's completely pointless if you don't act on it. How do I do that? First of all, you have to follow the four steps, the four points we already talked about. Second of all, I want you guys, I want to read the verse that says, it's James 1:22. And just follow the verse on the screen. And it says so beautifully, do not merely listen to the word and so deceive yourself. If you just come and listen to the word of God, you're actually deceiving yourself if you don't do what it says. We have to act on the word of God. It's enough that we listen to so many beautiful and strong and powerful sermons and studies in this church alone. It's time for us to act on the word of God. Now, how do I do that? The first one, it's picture it. It helps me a lot. When I read through the scripture and said, if you are with us, who can be against us? Just picture that. You have to go through a trial, right? And then just picture God being with you. Like picture you facing a huge army, but God is with you. When I picture that, I see all the army, all the problems vanishing away. And the open road is for me, so I can go on. Picture, when you read the word of God, picture what the word of God says. Pronounce it. What is so important to pronounce it? When I pronounce the words that I'm reading, they get stuck to my brain a lot better than only if I read them like with my lips or in my heart or with my mind. Pronounce it. Emphasize the word. And then the third one is personalize it. Put your name on it. When it says Israel went to the battle, put Gabriel went to the battle. Chipri went to the battle. Personalize it. Put your name on it. And then the fourth one is probe it. Try the word of God. Meditate and apply the word of God. See if the word of God works for your situation. Don't just sit idle. Don't just read it and say, okay, it's a nice word, it's a nice idea. Act on it. You know the problem with the humankind, like that was, it's about business. I was reading through financial magazine and saying that we have so many great ideas, but we don't get rich, or we don't get wealthy, or we don't prosper, is because we do not apply the idea we have in our brains, or we're too afraid to do it. We don't believe in our own ideas. We have an idea about a business, but if you don't act on it, it's not going to happen. And somebody else will take your idea and become wealthy. Same thing is with the Word of God. It's pointless if you just read through it, if you don't probe it. Try it, the Word of God. Try to see if the Word of God indeed, when it says, God is with you, indeed God is with you. When God says, try me, see what God's trying to say by that. And then the last one is pray. When you read the Word of God, pray after you read it. And ask that the Holy Spirit would bring to your remembrance everything that you write about. Just don't force yourself, and this is another Satan's tool. Don't force yourself in saying that if I don't read today, I'm going to hell. Or if I don't read today, God is not going to love me anymore. Don't put yourself in that trap. Remember, the main point of this subject is maintaining a heart for God. With other words, loving God. When you love somebody, you do all these things automatically. You do all these things automatically. You don't have to force yourself. And the last one, point six, I must trust in it. I must trust in it. That's my favorite one, because one thing that I learned through all my life is to trust in God. And I don't want to brag about it, but it's one thing that I'm good at it probably, is to trust God no matter what. I don't care if Satan comes upon me with armies and armies, I trust God. I know my situation sometimes is not the most beautiful ones, but I trust God no matter what. I remember when 4 years, actually it was 7 or 8 years ago in 2004, when I got in a car accident, I was desperate. I lost everything. I couldn't work. I got in so much debt. I was then at Unkyu Shitusha Akasa, and they were coming one time to me and said, Gabi, I don't want you to be desperate. I don't want you to lose your mind. I don't want you, we want to pray for you. And I knew that, I didn't lose my mind. I was concerned about my situation. But I never doubt God that even in those situations, He is with me. Amen. Now, in my conclusion, I don't want to put too much burden on your shoulders, but it's one thing that I want to ask you guys. It's kind of hard to understand or to remember everything we've been through for the past 4 or 5 months so far. But if you can remember these 6 points, will help you a lot. It did help me a lot too. Try to remember these 6 points from this last section. First, you have to build on the Word of God. Build on the Word of God. Then, feed on the Word of God. Live by the Word of God. Grow. Act on it. And the last one, trust in the Word of God. God bless you guys.